sometimes when it all seems so far away. But I look down onto the crowd and I know it's gonna change. And we're gonna keep the faith that we'll never end it.
Hello and welcome to HomeBhoys number 125. 125? That's a kind of poignant number for Celtic at the minute. But this is HomeBhoys number 125. 2 days ago you had the season finale. So here's another season finale. Who's for the hot seat? We had a few tweets today asking us to put a show on tonight. So Joe was unavailable. Paul was unavailable. So I'm coming off the bench, shall we say, and get dusted down the MacBook, blew off the cobwebs. We'll see how this goes. Jason's there on the line. You there, Jason?
I'm here, mate. I'm here.
Happy days, man. And we brought in another one of our ringers for the Carluke Shamrock ex TikTok. I'm not sure if he's still doing that podcast, but Johnny McKay, you there, Johnny?
How you doing, guys? Hail.
TikTok, man. Obviously, we've got a special show lined up tonight for obvious reasons. Neil Lennon has stepped in to the managerial role at Celtic on the heels of Joachim Mjalby, who'd already served his notice to leave. And we're now looking ahead to see who's going to be the next manager at Glasgow Celtic Football Club. We'll open up the lines maybe in 15 minutes or so, right? Don't call in straight away. We'll have a wee blether first, about Neil Lennon first, and then we'll move on to who we would like, who we think's in the running, all that kind of stuff. And you'll be able to call in with your own thoughts and fears. And already, if you're online and you're on Twitter and you're on the message boards, you're on Facebook, it's arguments are in full rage already, so which absolutely brilliant. I'm pretty excited, I'm gutted, but I'm excited at the same time. It's one of them. Do you know what I mean? So maybe Jason, first of all, right, a wee timeline, right? Obviously, the news was official today, kind of out of the blue, but without naming any names, of course, you got a bit of information yesterday lunchtime that you shared with the rest of the HomeBhoys team. So I don't know if you want to maybe just briefly go into that without obviously naming any names, but it was an ex-Celtic player, probably who you would say would be close enough to know what things are going on. But take it away, man.
See, I don't post on any Celtic message boards anymore. So I didn't really know, but by all accounts, this has been out there for a wee while. So I got a word yesterday. I'll not mention any names. No. That Lenny was for the off, and it was a done deal. That Larson was coming in.
As good as a done deal.
That Larson was coming in, but as I say, the first part has came through. Whether the second part will come through, I'm not sure. Mm-hmm. You know, I only shared with you guys what I heard, and then Paul checked the bookies, and the bookies were like Larson was at odds on at the time, I think, or whatever. Right. I don't know. But so as I say, that's all I know, and I'm absolutely gutted when it boils down to it. But I'm kind of excited as well, because Celtic as a club goes on. You know, one man isn't the club. You know, we love Neil Lennon. He'll go down as a legend. But I'm gutted for him, because I wanted him to be there for the long run. And I think there's been various various parts to him leaving. I don't know. I'm just making loads of stuff up, which you'll make stuff up. Right. Johnny will make stuff up. But I've got my own ideas why he left. And there you go. But it's happened now.
So, Johnny, as I said, Jason shared that with myself, Paul and Joe yesterday. And we were having a wee confab about it. And certainly one thing that struck me right away, but it'd been Henrik Larsson that was getting mentioned, an ex-teammate of his is as far as we'll go, as where it came from. But I still, it was like Jason, I didn't really share it about. I told a couple of boys that I sit with in the canteen at work for my lunch, and another guy I'm friendly with in Scotland. But I didn't, because it was one of them where you're thinking, could be nothing, seems a bit extreme, but we'll wait and see. But then, of course, at the end of the day, you get the news. One of my mates texts me, Lennon's gone. And I says, you serious? He says, aye. So you're kind of, because of what we heard yesterday, you're kind of like, my God, that seems to be coming true. And when the bookies rarely get it wrong, that kind of thing. So I don't know, Johnny, I mean, had you heard anything previous to the day, wee rumblings or rumours? Or, I mean, how what was the timeline for you?
So you hear the rumours. The rumours about Neil have been going for a wee while now, but I don't really pay any attention to them, to be perfectly honest with you. Yeah. But it was the bookies thing last night. I was just doing a couple of things in the house and I seen it on the TV that Henrik Larsson had been installed with some Glasgow bookmaker, 80-13,
right,
to be the new Celtic manager. And I says to myself, 80-13, that's a bit. I mean, I don't believe, as Jason says, when you see things on Twitter and Facebook and folk will text you and blah, 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 you're like, aye, whatever, until you get the hard facts. And then the day, it was actually my wife that phoned me and told me, and I'm quite baffled by the situation, to tell you the truth. I thought maybe Neil would have stayed at least another couple of years. Jason, you were saying that there might be other things. I mean, we might make things up, but I think maybe there's been times through the season, the league's been won for a few weeks now. I think there might have been behind the scenes a few meetings with Mr. Lowell, with Big Mialbe going. It looks to be more into it. Quite baffling for me, because the thing about it for me, when you leave Celtic, there's no many places to go that will take you further up the betting order, as I think. I think it's unfortunately for Neil, I don't think he's going up the way. I think he'll be going down the way. If he's going to get to the very top, he's going to have to take a step downwards.
I would agree with you.
See, well, there's somebody just tweeted there, keep in mind the bookies stopped taking money on Mark Hughes being Celtic boss last time around.
Right, one thing I'd like to qualify as well, see bookies, see we manage markets, is a lottery. The bookies don't know nothing.
Aye.
You know, they just, it's basically the price that'll drive it, and very, very volatile markets, and it's a cash cow for bookies.
What's happened there, Jason, what's happened there is one or two guys have went and lumped a big sum of money on Henrik Larsson at the Blue, and they've shit themselves.
And a big sum of money, you're talking a couple of hundred quid each.
Aye. And they've kind of shit themselves.
Sorry, guys, but it was the 80-13 thing.
Aye, but it's Johnny.
See, if that says to me it was 31-41, I wouldn't even bothered looking up at the TV, or if I stopped doing so, or if it was the radio that was on, I just can't remember to be precise. But when it says 80-13, I'm like, that's no lot. They open up.
It's because they're exposed to losing money, because that's only the one folk have bet. So that's how they've pulled it in. Do you know what I mean? So it's just they're just balancing their books.
Jason, if you think about, I think this morning actually the prices moved a wee bit, and I think Paddy Power actually had Paul Lambert as a 3-1 favourite. Neil Lennon had drifted. Henrik Larsson had drifted again.
See the thing is, see if they know Larson's getting installed. Larson will be closed. 1 to 1,000.
Aye, book will be closed, aye.
Aye, yep. Do you know what I mean? They'll not be taking any bets. So they don't know, you know, and if they were in, they know. So I still think, to be honest with you, Larson's the bet, because he ticks all the boxes for me. Well, he'll get bums in seats for rightly or wrong reasons. He'll be cheap.
Jason, then what you got? We'll come to that.
Right, okay.
We'll stick with Neil Lennon first, right? Because I think that's only fair. And then we'll is that fair enough? Then we'll go around the kind of candidates that are in our minds at the minute.
Yeah.
So, as you kind of touched on, like, for me, it's always kind of a shock when a Celtic manager leaves, because it's the Celtic manager, he's the skipper, he's the gaffer, he's your leader. When it's somebody like Neil Lennon, we said in the show, I'd be happy for Neil Lennon to be the Celtic manager for as long as he wanted to be the manager. But at the same time, I did mention a few weeks back that I thought Celtic had went back the way a wee bit this season, or certainly stalled. I didn't think we'd went any further forward. And at the same time, I didn't think it was a big shock, because Neil Lennon hasn't had this desire to manage in England. I mean, he really hasn't. He's dropped big hints. Now, the thing about it is, though, it's Norwich that's the one that's on everybody's lips, and people are saying he's done it. There's a three-man.
No, Norwich have signed a guy, Neil Adams.
Oh, have they?
All right, there you go.
Right, but that's kind of irrelevant. What I'm saying is, the thing is, you're thinking, well, how can you leave Celtic to go to Norwich? Is what I'm saying. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's in my mind. How do you go from being the manager of the Celtic Champions League to go to the Championship, whether it's Norwich or anybody else? Like, Norwich was just the team everybody was talking about.
Yeah.
So it was a shock to me in that it could be Norwich, but it wasn't exactly a shock to me that it's happened. Gordon Strachan said managers have a time span now in football. And maybe he's right, 4 years, maybe it was the right time for Neil Lennon to go. Now, to me, he's always seemed he's had a really cosy relationship with Peter Lowell on the Celtic board. I think he's particularly close to Dermot Desmond. So the story's coming out that it's maybe been because he's not happy with transfer budgets. I think there would have to be a big, massive change there for him to suddenly not be happy, because I think he would have known full well in advance how the club was going. And I mean, it's not any shock to me. There's not a lot of money to go and sign players and stuff like that. So maybe that's part of it, and he maybe just feels he can't take the club any further forward because of the constraints. I don't think the constraints are anything new, though, is what I'm trying to say.
Right.
So I know. We were speaking on another thing on Facebook, one of our mates, Gary McGeady, and he think he was pretty vocal about not being happy with Samaras going, which I wouldn't really back him on that, and obviously Ledley being let go. So what is your take on why you think, and this, of course, this is just pure speculation on our behalf, because his agent released a statement this morning saying that Neil Lennon wanted to thank Peter Lowell on the board for the support he's had throughout his time at Celtic, which is one of these things that you say, well, it's an obvious thing to say, but I think Neil Lennon's the kind of guy that he would be honest about why he was leaving the club if there was problems in the background. I don't think he's the kind of guy that would shy away from that, because we're not exactly talking about it. He's not exactly sticking a knife in by saying that I felt like I couldn't take the club forward on the budget that was made available to me. I think he'd be quite honest in that, maybe not to that exact wording, but you know what I mean? I don't think he'd be shy away from it.
He's learned a lot in the last 2 or 3 years, Neil Lennon. I think he's been in there and he's been trying to get a better budget to have better in the Champions League. I think they're off. Peter Long said to Adam that we'll never know, because Lennon's too clever. He's not going to upset any other chairman and jeopardise his chances of getting a job. We're saying that. He's a clever lad. He's a clever boy. I've met him a few times. I know you know him, Jason. Gentleman, great guy, good company. He's a time for everybody. And I think he's been clever about Harper. You might be right. Maybe a big time to go. It means no, it's just baffling for me. I just don't see where he can bet himself in this moment in time, maybe another year or two. Baffled, disappointed, but at the same time, wish him every success, but hopefully never ever comes back to haunt us. It's going to be the Celtic anyway.
Jason.
Are you getting a click? Can you hear Johnny or are you Harper? He's
breaking up a tiny wee bit, but it's coming to his end, like, no?
As long as it's all right for you.
It's not too bad, like, it'll be fine. But just, Jason, just before I get your kind of view on that, one thing that was in my mind as well, and this is just completely in my mind, like, no? This is based on nothing but something I was just thinking about. Maybe Neil Lennon, maybe the board looked at talked to Neil Lennon about the fact that he may be looking for a bigger challenge down the line even. And maybe he wouldn't be here next the following year or the following year after that. So would there be thinking in that this would be a good time to bed in a new manager for next season, given the fact that Sevco are probably going to get fast-tracked, get every break gone to make sure they're back in the top flight when as soon as they can be back in the top flight? Do you think that would come into it at all?
I think you need to qualify. They've never been in the top flight before, so they can't get back.
You know what I mean. Semantics. Didn't he start with that? Semantics pish.
I kind of don't agree with you in anything you've said, Harper, to be honest with you, mate. I reckon there's
well, no, I'm not saying that's what I think. I'm just flinging out scenarios here.
Aye, no, I'll give you my wee synopsis. This is, and to qualify this, I know nothing. It's factual. I'm just making stuff up. But this is my take on it. I kind of agree with what Johnny says. I reckon Lennon's been sold down the river a wee bit, and I think there's maybe been promises made here and there. I've got a feeling me Albie's left because he's probably been on washers compared to what assistant managers are on, and he's going to try and get a better job somewhere. This is my take on it. Because I think, by all accounts, Neil Lennon's on half the salary of super salary, you know, and getting Celtic into the Champions League and things like that. So Paul touched on it the other night. I don't think he's a very wealthy man to be in it. Well, and that's not true. Compared to a normal working guy like us in the street, he'll be a very wealthy man. But I just think there's a lot more money to be made in other places.
Yep.
You know, and although Johnny, you say Norwich is that's a step down, which it is in football terms, you're probably talking about he can double his wages.
Aye.
You know, and doubling your wages isn't a step back in your professional career.
No.
This green tinted glasses everybody's got, which I've got them as well, you know. I just think for a kick-off, when Sam Maras came out and spoke out against Peter Lowell, I think that was maybe a wee...
A sign.
Because I think Neil Lennon would have gave Sam Maras another deal.
I think,
especially last season, losing Wanyama, Hooper, and by all accounts, no making any play to keep them, Lenny was up against it to qualify for the Champions League, which he done, and he done fantastic. We get shown up in the Champions League, but at the end of the day, we get shown up. We were the fourth seeds in the group. We finished fourth. You know, that he done what he was tasked to do, was to get us in the Champions League. He's maybe thinking, say we lose Big Virgil, say we lose Fraser Foster, and Peter Law is expecting him to qualify for the Champions League again. He's maybe looked at this, as Johnny says, he's a clever guy. He's maybe looked at this and says, my stock's pretty high right now. There's a chance it'll go down. And there's a chance if I stay at Celtic another year and I don't qualify for the Champions League and say I don't win the treble.
That's in my mind, right?
Winning the treble in England doesn't mean anything anyway. They don't rate our league at all. So maybe he's been a bit astute and he says, I'll take my chances now. I know I'll need to take a provincial club. I know I'll need to do well with them down there. But then, if I do well with them, then I kind of get the crack at the Aston Villas. The Evertons, the Newcastles, the... You know, it's...
So, Jason, just let me cut on you there then, Jason. Do you believe then... Are you saying that you think Neil Lennon's walking away from Celtic without a job to go to?
I do. I think, and I don't think he would badmouth Peter Law, because I think Celtic's been really good to Neil Lennon. Neil Lennon, over the course of his career, must have made millions of pounds off Celtic. You know, he's been good to Celtic, but Celtic's been good to him.
Yep.
And I think he loves the club that much that he would never badmouth them. But I do think in Peter Law, we've got somebody there that needs to control absolutely every facet of the club. And that's my honest opinion. My honest opinion is Peter Law controls everything.
I agree with you, Jason.
I don't know that for a fact either, Johnny. I've just made that up. You know, but
I know that, but that's what I'm trying. I'll be trying to get at earlier on. I went away on a tangent. But what I think maybe Lennon says to himself this season, I'm not shutting his door this time. I don't think he has. I think he's got his case forward, as you say. I mean, his record's is second to none. He's won three titles and two Scottish Cups. I mean, that's good going. In the 3 or 4 years that he's been here, he says to himself, 3 years in the Champions League, one of the times in the top in the last 16, I'm going to chat Peter's door and say, right, come on, I'm looking for more money this season to try and take the team a step further. And as you say, he's probably going to, I think, we'll lose the goalkeeper anyway. and probably the big centre half. So I think he's every right to go up there. And I think maybe Peter Lowell thought he was going to lose the right with the manager. I think this is the time that Neely's went up and chapped the door and says, I'm after more money to strengthen the squad. Obviously, he's not going to get it. And he's done it with dignity. He's worked on the right way about it. No animosity. And he's on his way. That's the way it is. And although what I'm hearing today, after every day, there's four rounds on and all the rest of it, make a big deal of it. I think he's done it.
I thought you were going to say dignity there. I was going to cut you off.
I think also
we shouldn't forget what Neil Lennon's went through to be Celtic manager.
Yep.
And you don't know how much that still plays on his mind in the background with his family, how can I maybe hassle his boy maybe gets stuff like that. And I think the family life will maybe come into it a wee bit as well. I mean, as Jason says, this is just us completely blown in the wind, like, you know, we don't know. But these things, they all must take a toll, like, you know. I mean, obviously it's calmed down since the animals aren't in the league, like, you know. But the potential is always there, I think, for Neil Lennon. He still doesn't get treated with the respect he deserves for the media anyway. So that, I mean, when you roll it all in, maybe it is just the right time for Neil Lennon to leave the club. Like.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He's going, there's no day, he's going to be an average Celtic supporter's best wishes, as long as he's going back home, is there any effect on a Celtic result? We all wish him the best wherever he goes. If he goes anywhere, as you say, Jason, I don't think he has got a job lined up either. I think he's just said, well, why should I try and get a team that I think, personally myself, is going to be harder this season to get into the Champions League, because we could actually draw Malmo in the club qualifier, which will be played at Murrayfield. I mean, he's a clever guy. He's looked into every aspect of what's happened. He's got plenty of time to get after for Hull. I know he says we're concentrating, getting 100 points, you know, the goals and all the rest of it, but he's had time to think about his future. And he's definitely clever. A lot clever than people give him the...
Well, let's look at it maybe from another angle then. Just devil's advocate, right? Now, we know Celtic's dwindling season ticket sales, stuff like that. As do you think there's been any for the board side of this saying, well, maybe it's time for a change? Maybe they've thought it's time for a change. What I'm saying is it all Neil Lennon, or has there been anything for the board where they've said, maybe it's time for a change, maybe we need to do something here to ignite the support and obviously we're going to start talking about somebody in particular who would definitely do that if he came in. Does that play into it at all about trying to just get a bit of excitement, try to ignite the support, or am I completely off there?
You trying to say maybe Larson so we can sell out the season tickets, is that what you're saying?
Well, coming to him at last night, but was there an actual board thing where they thought we need to do something here, maybe things are just getting a bit stale, we need to just revamp and ignite the support?
If you go back to Neely's first cup final when we beat Motherwell, I can remember Dermot Desmond getting a microphone, putting his face up around the main doors at hand, and he says to him, is Neil Lennon going to get a contract? And he's saying, and Dermot Desmond says, aye, of course. And they're like, how long fun is that? For as long as he wants. So I think that they were quite happy with Neil doing the job. Honestly, I think this season he's looking to sell, I'm giving himself a bit of clout here. I'm going up the stairs to see if I can maybe get an extra few quid. And we know what Peter Law was like. That's his goal, isn't it? Money. And I think he's been told, no, you're not getting it, you'll
get
the same. What
comes
in, I'll go out, I think, is the
bottle
in there.
I'll tell you something else, staying on that theme, this appointment, this is a sort of very critical moment for Peter Lowell, this appointment, because there's managers out there, right, who because of their association with Celtic, probably more than anything else, right, and the fact that they're out of jobs, right, David Moyes and Owen Coyle and the like, right, who I can tell you right now, the majority of the supporters do not want these guys, for the people I'm talking to today, and what I'm reading online, right, so the majority of people I've seen and spoken to do not want the likes of Moyes or Owen Coyle anywhere near Celtic, so this is a critical appointment in that regard, because they need to get this right from a PR point of view, even because of the way the fans are maybe a bit apathetic with stuff at the minute. And they do need to drive ticket sales. We know for a fact how desperate they are, because I think I can mention they contacted us, wanting us to sell season tickets for them, which we didn't feel was our place as an independent network. Who we didn't do anything with sponsors, and we didn't feel it was right for us to do that on the website. I don't think I'm out of turn in speaking about that. And I think that shows you, because we're a podcast that they had a dig at not so long ago in their one of their closed meetings where they released the notes. And then a wee while later, they're asking for our help sort of thing. So there's a wee tidbit for the people who think we're sellouts as well, because obviously we're no sellouts, or we would be selling season tickets. So anyway, and that's just touching that as well. I feel a wee bit bad that we're in a position where we feel that we can't help the club in that way, but that's just the way we found ourselves. But that's a completely thing entirely. But Jason, just on that, what I was saying there, I mean, how critical is this for not just a footballing point of view, but driving season ticket sales, which is a massive thing at the minute. Jason, you passed it. Hello?
I can hear you, mate. I can hear you.
I don't know what's happened to Jason. Well, Johnny, what I was saying there, Jason's went off.
It is a critical decision for Mr. Moll. I probably never seen this coming, you know, Harper.
No, I'm just adding Jason.
You get him?
Just adding him now. He probably never heard any of that then. You there?
Aye.
Did you hear any of that, what I was just saying?
No, nothing.
I was saying, right, I'll go a little briefer this time then, right? I was mentioning about how critical this is for Peter Lawwell to get this right, because the majority of people I've spoken to, right, don't want the likes of Owen Coyle or David Moyes anywhere near Celtic, right? So, we're talking about Celtic, there's kind of apathy of a lot of supporters at the minute, dwindling season ticket sales, dwindling crowds. They've got to get this right. And, I mean, and I did mention the fact that, and I think it's all right to mention that Celtic contacted us and asked us to sell season tickets via the website, promote stuff for them. And we felt that wasn't our place as an independent Celtic fans network and website. And I think John Paul Taylor completely understood that. I think he actually expected us to say no, to be fair. And that was just, I say, Jason, that was a wee thing for the people who think we're sellouts, because obviously we're no selling them. So, but you know where I'm coming for this, and I think maybe we can start moving on then. We've been going half an hour about the guys who could be, who are up there. And for this, the thing about it is, the funny thing is, the favourites always just become because they've got some sort of connection to Celtic. To be honest, like, no. But what's your take on that there?
I'm going to reiterate for Neil Lennon what he done for this club, but what the guys lived through.
Definitely.
You know, and there isn't anybody else in Celtic's history that's ever walked in his shoes.
I was talking about that as well. Did you not hear any of that?
I didn't hear any, mate.
All right. No, you carry on yours, then.
No. I just like to... And wherever Neil Lennon goes in life, he'll always have a place in our hearts, you know, because what he's been through, but the bigots in this country and what they've tried to do to him, and what they're probably still trying to do to him, you know. But I think part of the reason Neil Lennon will leave with his head held high and he won't speak only of Celtic, because I think Celtic stood by him, and I think Peter Law was probably a good friend to him, you know. Because see, at the end of the day, see, as much as we're all against Peter Law at certain times and we think he's this, we think he's that, he does well for Celtic in the money sense. Celtic's a well-run business. you know, and he's the brains behind it. So we think he could do things a lot better, but he must be doing some things right. I know there's loads of stuff I'm totally against him with. There's loads of things I think he could do better, but I'm not in his position. And at the end of the day, he's got to do what he thinks is best for Celtic. And if that is not giving the money for the Samaras deal and not whatever Mialbi was needing or whatever, you know, I just think we need to go with him because nobody's bigger than the club. Nobody's big. Peter Long's no bigger than the club either. But he's tasked to do a job to balance the books, and that's what he does.
Fair enough. 100%, man. I agree with all that, aye. So,
aye, definitely. Aye, aye. He's got his own job that he's got to look after as well, aye.
Yeah.
So, right, let's move on then. I mean, we'll take calls. If anybody wants to call in, Jason, you've got the phone number?
The phone number is... Phone number is 0141 356 7327. So 0141 356 7327. If anybody wants to call in, I'll stick it in the chat room as well.
Right, and obviously you know the script. You can add HomeBhoys on Skype. And I'll try. I'm trying to keep an eye on Twitter here. It's not easy when there's only like 3 years. But I'm trying to keep an eye on Twitter here. But I'll keep an eye on people adding us as contacts if there's anybody new, and we'll get you on the show. But we'll probably only take one call at a time, and if we're going to get a lot of callers, we'll move through the callers. Maybe we'll not get any callers.
Yeah.
Who knows? You know how it goes. But so, as we mentioned, we might as well go straight to...
Who do you want?
Do you want to just go, who do you want, or do you want to... Well, wait a minute. Well, we've got... I can guarantee here's Alistair. All right, Alistair. You've been sitting there. You've been sitting there with your finger on that wee dial.
All right, mate. It's a bad line. So, no, pal. But obviously, I've got to do about the day's news, especially because I kind of started going to the games here and away under Martin O'Neill. So Neil Lennon was a big hero of mine, so obviously got Eden, and just wanted to know what you guys thought of the statement Celtic released. I thought it wasn't good enough.
Well, that's the kind of statement. That's a politically correct statement. That's what they're always going to do. They're going to just say thanks for that. That's just all you're going to get. Do you think they're going to come out and tell you some murky news? Do you know what I mean, mate? That's just the way it is. That's business.
Well, we'll never know. We'll never know what's been going on in the background. It's probably been going on for weeks now, the talks between Neil's agent and we'll never know.
I get one.
I will.
Well, you're the man, mate.
I get one day Sunday. And obviously, they've been talking this for a while. And it really started Sunday, Monday was really when it started cutting off, and then of course the mainstream media got hold of it, and then all of a sudden it was this morning. But no, it's just, I don't know if you think of this, but Malcolm Mackay with Henry Laughlin is he number two?
No chance. Henrik Larsson shouldn't play number two to anybody.
No.
I know, but I'm just thinking maybe Malcolm Mackay for a couple of years, then Henrik will take care.
What's Malcolm Mackay ever done? Took Cardiff up to the Premiership. Took him up to the Premiership, right? Cardiff City won the Championship with him, or took him up through playoffs or whatever. I'm not really caring, to be honest with you.
No, you're just no anybody other than boys, eh, Jason?
But what's that?
Anybody other than boys, eh?
Well, if it's not David Boys or Malcolm Mackay will be back in the running. But that's about the strength of it.
I agree with you guys. It's just, I just think the timing's been lousy if we lose Virgil Foster and maybe a couple of others, you're not exactly giving the manager a great crowd and bought the ball going, are you?
Alistair, right,
But
wait a minute, Johnny.
Sorry, mate.
Johnny, wait a minute, right? I've heard this a lot. The timing's no great. But this, Neil Lennon was never ever going to leave Celtic during a season. He's on a 1 year rolling contract, right? So Neil Lennon was never going to be getting sacked. Neil Lennon was always going to be leaving at the end of the season if he was going to leave. And to me, he's actually left pretty quick, considering the season's just finished. I think the board's probably known that he's going to have been leaving. Probably that's how me Albies came out first. They would have known then. I'd say this has been, and I'd say, I would imagine that things will be pretty advanced, and I think a new manager will come in pretty quick. It wouldn't matter if it was the end of this season, the end of the following season. We'd always be in the same boat, getting a new manager. It was always going to be at the end of the season. Do you know what I mean? I don't know how the timing could be any different, to be honest.
But what the thing is, Harper, I know Jason, with the sounds of Jason, he's wanting Henrik Larsson. Yeah. Am I right, Jason?
I'd love him.
Well, I'll tell you what, you're going to throw that guy out at the deep end in this Champions League qualifiers.
I know.
I agree with you, Johnny.
Johnny, but who's not going to be in the deep end? Who's going to be in the deep end?
We're going to find out. I knew this today. I says, he's going to fight me. Know who I would have in a heartbeat? David Moyes. And I know I didn't want him at Everton. I'm telling you.
It's a no for me.
Johnny, you came down to watch Everton with me for years.
He had a limited squad to get results. He knows the game inside out.
He had a limited squad for the Man United.
He'd never had a limited squad. He had a team of prima donnas that didn't give the guy a chance.
You're talking about somebody hitting the ground running. Fucking didn't exactly hit the ground running at Old Trafford, did he?
No, I agree with you there. But they had a team of prima donnas in the dressing room.
They may have had prima donnas at Celtic.
Well, I don't think so.
Here's another thing, right? David Moyes at Everton was on £60,000 a week. Man United with a more than doubled that.
That's right.
Lenny's own, what?
£400,000,
that's about £38,000 a week. £38,000 a month.
David Moyes, when he was at Everton, says if anybody ever gets approached for a Celtic job, regardless who they are or what team they're with, they need to consider it.
Look,
it's only my opinion.
Well, that's fair enough. But the thing is, see the Celtic job, there's going to be a queue the size of Sucking Hall Street on that job. Don't go out there under any illusions about that.
Malky Mackay, Loudrop, they're mentioning tonight. Fuck off. Coyle, Clark, Lambert, and Henry Larsson, a guy who terrified he gets a job in case it all goes tits up more than anything. The guy's managing fucking second-rate teams in Sweden. Well, we want him to come, one of the greatest players ever to play for the Celtic.
Well, Ballamy Hill was the greatest captain ever, and we want him to be the manager.
But he'd done his time at Aberdeen and Clyde first before he came to Celtic.
Johnny, Neil Lennon never done his time anywhere.
Exactly, did they win there?
Aberdeen, he done well with Aberdeen. It was Aberdeen's, it was Ballamy Hill's team that fucking Ferguson took care of it.
But Johnny, Neil Lennon went in at the deep end, didn't he, managed anywhere?
He had been around about Celtic with Strachan and the backroom staff.
But he still wasn't a manager.
He was in the new Scottish football inside, right? All right, St. Larsson did. He is in a plain sense. The guy's in Sweden managing fucking second rate teams, come on. Season tickets for Peter Law and go and play two qualifiers at fucking Murrayfield and all when they're nearly there, and you know that as well. You're throwing this guy in at the deep end, and honestly, I love him to bits. Don't get me wrong, if he gets a job, I'm 100% behind him. But as you say, Jason, the queue won't be long, but they're your top men, they're the top five or six.
We spoke on the show the other night about getting somebody in for left field, getting a bit of invention in, getting a bit of some continental style in. You know, getting somebody with a bit of vision to change. So you're about to go to Davy Moyes, that's the most dour British type manager, defensive minded, fucking man management bullshit. You know, you're
one of the guys that nobody's brought up. Roberto Di Matteo.
No danger.
European experience.
I've had my full David Moyes.
Alistair, Alistair, just before we let you go, who do you want to be the next Celtic manager?
Honestly.
Aye. I don't want you to lie to me.
Honestly, possibly Steve Clark.
Steve Clark.
Or Alistair.
Honestly. European experience, knows how good a coach he's got to be.
But that's what we need because we can't even buy players. We need somebody that can make players better. So I certainly don't want to own Coyle. That's a no-no for me. You know, get back once, you don't get another opportunity. Fair enough. Well, that's David Moyes, isn't it? Did he not get back once? <laughs> Well, I don't think David Moyes ever won anything in his life. Certainly as a manager, he's never won anything. Ever. Never won anything. He's a loser.
Well, he never won the league with Celtic a couple of times.
No,
just
as a manager. As a manager.
Me and you argued about this when he was at Everton. I didn't want him. I wanted him out of Everton after 2 or 3 years. And I give you the benefit of the doubt. He done well. He kept Everton wherever they were in the league. He had a chance to get into the Champions League, into Europe, with a team with limited resources. And he's going to come into Celtic. He'll not have as much money to spend, obviously, but he can win that league, and he knows he's managed against the best.
He can win.
He's been the manager against the best players.
Arsene can win the league.
Right, wait a minute. Right, you two are just going to go back and forth there, right? I'm just like, Alistair, I'm just going to...
Boys has got a record in Europe, he's done absolutely nothing.
Hang on the new boys. Hang on the new, right? Because I had a request there to add in, so... Alistair, I'm just going to let you go, man. Thanks for calling in, buddy.
I'm eating that one.
Can I see there's a couple of points, Johnny, and very valid points you brought up about hearing it last night. Now, I'll not make any bones about it. I'm totally with Jason this. For me, I'm looking at it for a posted a thing today. Somebody says to me, why is Henrik Larsson a more suitable candidate than Malky Mackay? And I says, because he's Henrik Larsson.
Yep.
Because I want someone, for the minute I heard that yesterday, I've been excited. More excited than I've been about Celtic in a long time. The exact same excitement I had when I thought Neil Lennon was going to get the job. I want him to get the job for who he is. Honestly, right? You can talk about the wee clubs in Sweden and that, right? I don't know if the Swedish league's any better or worse than the Scottish league. It's probably on a par, right? Obviously, he's not clubs the size of Celtic, right? He's been a manager for 5 years, right? I don't know how long he's got to be a manager. He's cutting his teeth the right way, I think, at the bottom. He's starting at the bottom where he should start, right? And he's done his 5 years. I don't know what kind of resources, what kind of success he's having in Sweden. I don't know what chance of success he's got in Sweden. But if this job's made available to Henrik Larsson, I think he should jump at it. Honestly believe he should jump at that job and put in somebody beside him. We're not talking, Henrik Larsson's going to do it all himself. Put in somebody that he trusts beside him. Why not? I mean, I'm desperately want Henrik Larsson. I'll go a second with Paul Lambert. But apart from that, I don't want anybody else for the UK leagues. I'm not interested in Owen Coyles or the David Moyes or the Malky Mackays. I was listening to the HomeBhoys show Monday night, I wasn't on it, and the boys were talking about assistant, as Jason was saying, someone totally for left field, and I'd be up for a Wim Jansen coming in right out of the blue, if you know what I mean, that kind of style, if it wasn't Henrik Larsson. But I am desperately wanting Henrik Larsson to get that job, and it would ignite my passion again completely. I'm so excited at the fact that there's a chance I might get it. Now, just before I let you come back on that, right, there was one thing that, and this could be completely out of the blue, right? And I've no heard. Eamon, I'll bring you in a second. There's no video, Eamon. Sorry, right? I'll bring you in a second, right? There's a name that came into my head, right? And everybody's going to say no. Right, let me explain it first, right? Now, the name's Roy Keane, right? Now, wait a minute.
No chance.
Wait, the reason, my reasoning behind, I'm not saying this who I want, right? Dermot Desmond is going to have the massive say in who the next manager of the Celtic is going to be, right? Now, I don't know if you know this, but Dermot Desmond and JP McManus fund Martin O'Neill and Roy Keane. They were that desperate. They wanted them to be the managers of the Ireland. They're funding the majority of their wages for the FAI. Delaney even came out and spoke about it on television, right? So that is what I'm trying to say is that is the kind of regard that Roy Keane and Martin O'Neill are held in by Dermot Desmond and JP McManus, who are obviously going to have a heavy influence on what's going to happen here. I'm not saying that's going to happen, but I'm just saying that's something that could come out of the blue that wouldn't be a complete surprise to me because of the relationship he's got with Dermot Desmond.
I would be absolutely astounded.
I'm just putting it out there.
Nah, just take that away. Get rid of it. Roy Keane, club management. Roy Keane's never a football manager. Roy Keane, if he's got 11 players in that park and they're shy, he's going to tell them they're shy. And how are they going to perform for him?
But why did they desperately want to get him into the Ireland job, they two?
You better ask them.
But that's what I mean. These are the guys that are in control of Celtic. That's what I'm saying, Jason. These guys are in control of Celtic.
But then Ireland, it's different from a national team. You know, there's no chance Roy Keane's coming to us. No chance.
I don't want him. If he came. I don't want him, but I'm just saying, I'm just putting it out there.
I think you're miles out there, Harper. I don't even think that's worth covering, to be honest.
Right, okay. Right, so anyway, we've got a caller, Eamon Coyle. All right, man, this first time calling in,
how you doing, Eamon? You all right, mate?
Yes, how's it going, mate? I was just wanting to throw my cup and swath in here in terms of who the future Celtic manager could be. I think I love that. I mean, my heart tells me that Henrik Larsson would be amazing and that he's obviously a club legend and all. And if he walks through the door as a manager, I'd be delighted in that. But at the same time, I'm a wee bit concerned that there's a lot of emotion attached to Henrik Larsson becoming the manager because he's somebody who we all love, obviously, and all cherish as a legend. But I just get the impression that people are going, yeah, get Henrik in. And it's just kind of like one of these things where, I mean, I don't know how much of a proven manager he is. But, and as I say, I would back him all the way if he became the club manager, but at the same time, I think there's a lot of kind of emotive chat about Henrik being a legend and just bring him in on that basis kind of thing.
I totally agree with you. I'm totally admitting that I'm getting carried away in this wave of emotion. Absolutely, but what in life isn't it a gamble? You could get Jose Mourinho in here and they could fail.
Exactly. And I know Lennon was a gamble as well, and it was partly...
Exactly.
He was obviously a Celtic man through and through. The only thing I was going to say, I don't know if you've mentioned, I've only caught on to the last maybe 10 minutes or so of the programme, but I was thinking somebody who knows the club inside out and knows Scottish football inside out, and he's kind of cut his teeth in the last couple of years, maybe 3 or 4 years in management, would be Jackie McNamara.
Yeah.
I think he could be a good shout. He's got the temperament, he's got the football and philosophy, I think, and I think he could do well, you know, him and possibly Sid Donnelly, you know. I don't know, he might be pissed off at the fact that the way he was treated when he left the club as a player, but I think as a manager he could do well and it'd be worth a gamble.
I wouldn't disagree there as well. You know, it's like if he comes he'll get my full back. You know, he's not going to get the juice. He's gone with the return of the King would. But he's cut his teeth to be part of Thistle, Dundee United. He's had sort of limited success, but absolutely I think he's got a good head in his shoulders. And
Jason,
yep,
I agree with you say, Eamon, Jason, about wee Jackie and Sid. They're doing great. But do you not think, come August, I mean, we've been saying it for the last few years, our biggest game of the season will be in August. Yes. If we get to the qualifier to get to the Champions League. Now, if they're not going to give Neil Lennon any money, they're not going to give to Jackie or Sid, who have got absolutely no experience playing in Europe. They did play in Europe, I'll give them that. But management-wise, no. I mean, the two of them couldn't beat St Johnstone in the cup final. We need to get into the Champions League. It's as simple as that.
So, Johnny,
if we don't get into the Champions League, Jason, you can hear me and you will still be there. And Eamon probably will still be there. And Harper. But the thing being is, if we don't, that next season is going to be one damn squad. It's imperative we get into the Champions League.
But this is what I'm trying to say to you. We could get Jose Mourinho and there is no guarantee we'll get into the Champions League because you've only got the players that you can put out there and we're not going to put a team of world beaters out there. But it'd be right, we've got a good chance of getting into the Champions League because we can only get winners of the provincial nations in Europe. But there is no guarantees, mate. So no. there is nothing you can do. So what do you?
I agree with you.
Let me put some of you the note. What are you right? You're Peter Long. What are you going to do to ensure we get into the Champions League?
Well, I can assure you what he's doing. Now he's scratching his head. He hasn't got a clue. I don't think there's anything.
What would you do?
Well, I've told you what I would do. I think the best gamble to take is David Moyes to get us into the Champions League.
And how much are you going to pay him?
Well, that's up to David Moyes and Peter Lowell. I don't know.
No, but you're Peter Lowell for 10 minutes. How much are you going to pay David Moyes? What's the most you're going to go to?
I haven't got a clue what the Celtic's budget is. I do not know.
Well, see, Lenny's own roughly. Lenny's on $10,000 a week. David Moyes was on $140,000 with Man United. So are you going to meet in the middle and give him $70,000?
Of course he's not. But what I'm saying to you, David Moyes did say, regardless of where you're in the world or what team you're with, Celtic
come. David Moyes said quite a lot of stuff.
Oh, come on, mate. Come on. We need. You know I'm right. Right. We need to get into this Champions League.
What was
that? Johnny.
Europe. When David Moyes took them to Europe.
It's not to do with Everton. Sorry,
Just to say, I know you're talking about getting into the Champions League, and it's obviously essential. And we kind of like, obviously, in the last couple of years we've been there. But the thing is, remember on Lenny's first season, everyone thought we were going to get, well, hopefully into the Champions League and then maybe the Europa League, if not, and it turns out we get nothing. And that was one of the best seasons I can remember as a Celtic fan, see, in terms of the, I know we'd only won the Scottish Cup, but in terms of the unity amongst the Celtic fans, and obviously there was a lot of other things happening, but first season under Lennon was one of the most memorable, you know. And admittedly, like, you know, we're still in the league, but I think, you know, it obviously is essential, but I think Jackie McNamara or even Henrik Larsson would probably have a better chance or as much of a chance as David Moyes or anybody is getting us into the Champions League. And besides David Moyes, I mean, I don't know, I don't think he's really, I think he'd probably want another job in England. And I think he'd be demanding quite a lot of money to manage Celtic as well. I don't think he's really a goer, to be honest.
See, another thing you're touching on about experience to manage in Europe and that, I mean, none of these names that are getting flung about have probably managed in Europe. Your own Coyles and your Malky Mackays. Do you know what I mean? Did Cardiff play because they won a cup or something? I'm not sure, but none of them have had any success in Europe. David Moyes certainly never had any.
Didn't either, no. Beat 5-0 with Dinamo Bucharest, I think it took Everton there. It was 5-0 to Dinamo Bucharest. That was good.
Well, they nearly got to win the Champions League and get robbed.
Well, Villarreal, they probably should have done better, but they didn't. They only had one game to play, or two, was it one or two? So at the end of the day,
that's right, Jason, you're a big fan of Moyes, then.
Jason, we might not even be in the Europa.
Johnny, okay. You've got this year's Champions League is so important. Tell me why it's so important, this year's Champions League.
Jason, I'm just talking on Celtic as a whole. No, for me personally, I'll be there every week regardless.
Right.
But you know, and I know, Eamon knows, and so does Harper, if we don't get in that Champions League or Europe, the fans will not go.
Well, that's their choice.
Right, and then that's the budget away for the next year as well.
They'll go if Henrik Larsson's a manager.
But what
if he doesn't get us in?
They'll still go.
Johnny, we've had 2 years in the Champions League. What budget have we got this year?
Probably the same, but if we don't get in it, then the next year it won't be near it.
I think part of the reason Lenny's off is because of the lackey budget, and that's
right, exactly.
That's with 2 years in the Champions League, so it doesn't really matter, does it?
Well, we're going to eventually we'll agree on Sunday at the end of the night, and it'll be Henrik Larsson.
But see, Johnny,
I was touching a good point, which is that whoever comes in will get 100% backing.
Well, that's definitely
the
case, yeah.
Definitely.
But see, Eamon, you made an interesting point, right, about Neil Lennon's first season, right? Neil Lennon got a bye on that first season because he was Neil Lennon, right? Owen Coyle wouldn't have got that same bye in his first season, in my opinion. Henrik Larsson would. Now, Johnny, Henrik Larsson would sell X amount of season tickets just for the fact that Henrik Larsson's back at Celtic, right? So those fans would still be there if we never made the Champions League.
Would still have season tickets?
Huh?
They wouldn't be there.
I think they would. No, I think they would. I think it would. I think it would have the same effect as Eamon spoke about in Lennon's first season. Honestly,
I
really
My
heat's on
other place with
that, so
honestly, I'm baffled
by it.
I really am.
What about another name then that we've not even touched on yet? Paul Lambert. Which Paul Lambert for me is the only other guy in sort of UK football, if you like, at the minute, who I would like to see come at Celtic. I mean, I don't know, Eamon, what would your thoughts be on, you mentioned Jackie McNamara. I mean, is that who you want? What about like, say, Paul Lambert? And again, Paul Lambert's on big money at Aston Villa.
As I've already said, because he was kind of like, he obviously knows the game in Scotland inside out, and he knows Celtic well and all that kind of stuff. And he seems to have a good temperament, a good head on his shoulders. But Paul Lambert, I don't know. I think he's kind of, to be honest with you, I don't really know. Maybe I'd take him and I'd say I'd back him 100% if he got the job. But I think he's already said he doesn't really want to come back up to Scotland to manage, is he not?
I kind of see him taking it. I would love to see Lambert there. I really think the world of Paul Lambert, especially.
So the as a player, he was brilliant.
His experience in Dortmund and things, he could bring things to the table. But I would kind of like something for that left field. You know, I mean, it's even Jackie Mack and Sid, they're not going to bring in for left field. They're going to, I don't know. But it's just, I think we've got a chance now to put our mark in the club and maybe take the club in a slightly different direction with style of football and whatever. Somebody with a better vision, and I think maybe doing I think Larsson could bring that. You know, I think the guy's a bit of a genius, and I just think somebody like that could, you know, he's obviously played for the best clubs in the world.
He's annoyed at Jason.
One thing about Henrik Larsson would be that I think more than anybody, I think there's talk of, you know.
Oh shit! You know, fucked up. Sorry, man. Sorry.
Hello?
Sorry, I cut you off there. He's back.
Cut me off again, did he?
He's back.
I'm back.
Yeah. I hate just shut down a couple of calls that were trying to come in. So I went.
Eamon's better off hanging up and phoning instead of the voice, the video.
Well, Eamon, sorry, actually, Eamon, I've actually got another two callers lined up, man, so I'm actually going to let you go.
You had a point there, Eamon, on you go.
What's
that? You were going to say a point there before.
Aye, one thing I was going to say about Henrik Larsson is that I think he might be somebody who, more than anybody else, would be able to kind of, he seems to have a bit of gravitas about him in terms of maybe sort of going in and saying, look, I need X amount of money, you know, and having a bit of sort of, I want to stand up to loyal and say I need this, I need that. But a McNamara might not do that. I don't know.
I think if Henrik Larsson was to go to Spain or go to wherever and say to somebody, do you want to come and play with me? And it's Henrik Larsson, you know, that's about a clown itself.
He's played in Barcelona, maybe Man United,
and they've got
he's a convincing man. No, Jason, sorry, Eamon, see, just retouching that earlier, I think that's maybe one of the reasons why Lennon's left. I think he's went and chucked Peter Lowell's door. So I don't think Lowell's prepared to get somebody in. There's going to be up Champions door every now and again for a few quid.
But I kind of agree with you, Johnny.
Right. Right, Eamon, I'm going to let you go because I've got another three callers lined up.
No worries, Eamon,
that was brilliant, mate.
Alright,
take care,
Eamon.
Cheers, mate.
Take care, guys.
Cheers, man.
Cheers, bye.
Right, I'm going to just add Brendan into the call, if he's still online. Brendan, there he is. Add, and then we'll have Snake Pilskin, and then Terry O'Neill after that. If you're still listening, I have got you lined up. Brendan, switch off your speaker, man.
Yeah, I'll just turn it off, Harper.
Right, man, you're live on the HomeBhoys. What do you want to say, man?
Well, obviously gutted that the news that Lenny's gone. All the potential managers you're mentioning, there's no guarantees with any of them, whether it's Moyes, whether it's Larsson. Whoever we take on, they've still got to do it, haven't they? I mean, like Jason says, I think Larson just gets the juices going, doesn't it?
Does for me.
I mean, a lot of people are worried that he'll taint his reputation as a player, but that's a chance. But that's a chance you take, Jason, isn't it?
Exactly, mate. Exactly. Why worry about a season late?
If it turns out to be a disaster, that's just the way it goes. At least you gave him a chance. When we gave Lennon a job 4 years ago, I mean, after the semi-final against Ross County, and we lost, there's a lot of people did. Well, Lennon's the manager.
Yeah.
But he's done great things for Celtic over the last 4 years, so if we can get Larson, let's get him on board.
I totally agree with you, mate. Kenny Dalglish was a disaster when it came back to Celtic. Is that tainted to his reputation with the Celtic support?
Well, look, Kenny Dalglish was my favourite player when I was young.
You know, is he still your favourite player when you were young? Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Exactly.
Definitely.
Exactly. And all this doom and gloom, like, if this happens, if that, if nothing, just get it done.
It's meant to be able to happen, won't it, Jason? Let's put it that way.
Exactly, mate. And as we've said before, Alistair mentioned that we're going to support whoever it is. But I just think, I'm not a very kind of emotional kind of guy. I'm quite cold-hearted when it comes to football. And I know a lot of them are in it for money and stuff like that. But Henrik Larsson, to me, as far as I'm concerned, he's the greatest player that's ever pulled the hoops on. I know people will argue. My dad thought it was Bobby Murdoch. People think it was Jinky. A lot of people think it was Kenny Dalglish, Danny McGrain. You know, there's been many great players there. But to me, Henrik Larsson, to me, was everything. And I think the way that he went and proved it in the world stage after he left us. And I just loved watching him for Celtic. You can watch his goals all day long. And it's just when he left, you know, that final game when he went off at Hampden after we'd won the cup, I'd like a wee tear in my eye. I was like, I can't believe I'm feeling like this, you know, after the guy playing this. But if he come back, I'd walk into Celtic Park to welcome him. You know, I'd love it. But whether it's going to happen, I don't know. But I just, he's a, I've not got many heroes in life, but he's kind of a guy I would look to as a bit of a hero, definitely.
Well, the thing is, whoever comes on board, let's be honest, should win the league next season. The league should be a given with our resources and our players.
Agreed.
You can put that one to bed. The big thing is like, who's the other one tonight? I don't know. Who's the other panellist tonight?
Johnny.
Yeah, well, Johnny says I think the Champions League, I think we've got to get in there just from a financial point of view.
Yeah.
Because obviously, looking at the accounts, it shows if we don't qualify for the group stages, it leaves a massive hole in our finances. Which then means they're more likely to pump players to try and recoup some of that money.
I think it does, but in a Scottish context, does it? You know, does it weaken our position in the Scottish Premier League? No, it doesn't. You know, I mean, they're all the money we spent last year, apart from Big Virgil. You know, the money we spent, you're looking at how much it was spent wisely.
Well, yeah, exactly.
You know, but we spunked how many millions, and we've got nothing to show for it. But at the end of the day, we always get a couple of rough diamonds. And Big Virgil's one. We've still got Foster. Obviously, he was signed the season before. But with Wanyama and Hooper and things like that, we've made real good business. But, I mean, Boricta and, you know, the money with Baldy, the money we spent last year, for the majority of it was pissed up against the war, really.
Got a tweet here for Tom Doherty, right, at Funny Handshake on Twitter. Just throwing a name in for the discussion that the Cheapskate board might consider Willie McStay. No chance. No chance.
Celtic Nation.
Right. As well, give it to John Kennedy.
Brendan, so listen, just I want to move on because we've got other callers lined up. Who do you want as the next Celtic manager?
Obviously Larson, he's top of the list for what we spoke about. I would have liked to see Jackie Mack there, but I think it's probably a year, maybe 2 years too early for him. I think he showed with Dundee United against St Johnstone. He couldn't beat St Johnstone, so is he ready to step up to Celtic? Again, you don't know. It's a chance you take. I think for me, yeah, let's go with Larson. All the ones that have been mentioned. He can only fail, but if he's successful, how good would he be?
I know.
Okay, Brendan.
One point right. Before you go, Brendan, here, I'll just wait till Brendan goes. Liam texts me, Brummie boy, and he says he can't ring in, but he says a point to raise here is Lenny has had minus net spend each of his four seasons he's been at Celtic. So he says, in that regard, the club's unlikely to provide any real cash to any new manager, which would suggest a Jackie or Owen Coyle over a bigger name. Cheers, that's Liam's point. So, as I say, Lenny said net minus spend. I think you can maybe qualify that because the money we get moving Yama and things like that, you're maybe not going to get that every year. Then you would have to kind of spend some money. But he makes a fair point. Owen Coyle, would Owen Coyle be a cheap option? I think he kind of would. Jackie Martin would be a cheaper. Larson would be a cheap option.
The whole thing about Owen Coyle is he's not going to put bums in seats. Everybody's just got to roll their eyes.
For the vast majority of the fans are totally
against the board has to know that.
Harper, if the board, if Coyle gets the job, it just shows you how little the board know about how the fans feel. He had the chance to get it, 4 years ago? He knocked his back, shouldn't get a second bite, and I think that's a lot of feeling. Look on Twitter, Facebook, a lot of fans feel the same way. He's had his chance and it's gone. If they give him the job now, it's just going to turn even more fans off.
I think there'd be a revolt, to be honest.
In the chat room, I want to bring up here, there's a guy, Jeb, in the chat room. He says, quite a few folk are saying they disagree, but he actually says, if Larson fails as a manager, his legacy will be forever tainted.
No chance.
What do you think of that, guys?
No, I understand that, right?
I don't understand that at all.
Well, I know, I understand how people think that, right? Because you think, what Tony Mowbray was... No, it's not in the same class as Henrik Larsson, right? Tony Mowbray was a great servant at Celtic, right? And the first thing I think of when I think Tony Mowbray is his disaster as a manager, right? So I think that's obviously the point he's trying to make, right? That, I'm not saying he's comparison to Tony Mowbray, but that's what he's saying. He doesn't want Henrik Larsson. But to me, Henrik Larsson is much, much, much bigger than that. It's much, much bigger than that. When it started to go wrong for Billy McNeil, it didn't taint Billy McNeil's reputation. Do you know what I mean?
Exactly.
So no, I can't see that being either. Like maybe it would be for Jed Boy, but
Jed's entitled to his opinion, absolutely. But I just don't see it at all. Absolutely no way.
Sorry for butting in. I remember when Kenny Dalglish's last game in as manager. Wasn't his last, it was at Ibrox, so we got beat 4-0. Now I heard the Celtic support that day in Kenny Dalglish. And Kenny Dalglish was you'd say Henrik Larsson or whatever. Kenny Dalglish is probably one of the best Celtic players of all time.
Yeah.
And the abuse he was getting through the Celtic fans that day, albeit probably none of them ever seen him and didn't realise how good he was at the time.
Yeah.
And he'd done a few things that did interviews with fucking journalists. I don't know why he ever done it and that. You know what I mean? And it did taint his reputation. I mean, guys my age and your age remember him and love him as a football player, but as a person, I think it changed a lot of the views on Kenny. I would hate that to happen to Henrik Larsson. I know you see it as a different point of view. Don't worry, that's onwards and upwards sort of thing.
The thing is, Johnny, you covered the point there. See the people that would be supporting Celtic just now. Every one of them just about seen Henrik Larsson in the hoops.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so the Dalglish was for a bygone era for a lot of people. You know, so they'd never seen him, so that was just a material to them.
They didn't have that connection.
Aye, so Larson's got that connection. Sorry, he's still, the blood's still hot with Larson.
Right, listen, I want to keep moving things on, right?
Right, I'll turn off, Harper. All the best, lads.
Cheers, Brendan.
Cheers.
Bye-bye. Right, I know Snake Pilskin is next, and then Terry O'Neill, if you're still listening, Terry, I'll get you on after Snake. Shit. I've done it again. I've only had 2 gin and tonics. Fucking fucked up again.
I'm back.
You need to add to call. No, hang up.
Right, add to call. I've only had 2 gin and tonics, for fuck's sake.
Right, there you go.
Right, add snake. Snake Plissken, right, add. Now, I'm poor Joe, I take it all back, Joe. I'm always slagging him. take it all back.
You there, hear me?
Aye. I can hear you, man.
I don't know if he's a lover of Craig Bellamy, but he retired today as well. He's
34. Yeah. Right, first thing I think you hear Craig Bellamy is no signing that Huns top at the airport.
Aye, brilliant. Bellamy. I was speaking earlier, he scored a hat-trick at Tannadice. I don't know if you remember, it's the best hat-trick I've ever seen in my life.
We were going neighbour that game. He won that game single-handedly for us. We wouldn't even have took the game, the league, to the last day of the season if it wasn't for
him. Yeah, definitely, if it wasn't for him. You're right, Jason, that was
See, yeah. Is a baseball term. Was that not? Did they not do the cycle that day? Left foot, right foot, heater? No?
I don't think it was a heater, was it?
Was it not? Popped in my head. Right, anyway, we've got our next caller. Snake, thanks for being patient and hanging on there, man. You're live on there. What was it you watched there?
Hi, lads. Big surprise, I suppose. well, what a day. I've been able to think and talk about this most of the day because I've been working most of the bloody day as usual. But, here's my thoughts on this. Sad to see Neil go, but it's up to him. And whatever his reasons are, we'll always thank him for the good years. And wee Strachan was right. Managers have only got a shelf life here, about 5 years at a club these days. So, time for a change. And talking about the change, here's what I think. We need to think, what are the short-term and longer-term goals for Celtic? Short-term is obviously to get into this Champions League again. And longer term, the fans are looking at this and chant about every week, here we go, 10 in a row. So whoever we're picking now, the appointment has to be somebody that's going to be there for a longer time. They've got a year, I would say, as a buy. They're going to have another league title because we know, barring an absolute disaster, we will be champions in another year.
Yep.
So we need to have somebody in there that's really wanting to drive the team on for the next few years. That's what I think. And I'm the Larson thing interests me, but I would be quite happy to see Henry coming in with a number two that we all kind of recognise or think can add something to it. Because Henry Larson, well, he's all right, he'll get more bums on seats and he'll get more folk interested in the club and the glamour and all the rest of it. A shout, I think, might be a good one to bring in alongside him. Could be to phone up Morten Wieghorst. Because I think he's been let go of Swansea now. He's got another one that's not going to be working.
Well, see, just on that point then, right, I'm not mentioning any names again, but we were talking about Henrik Larsson today, and somebody said to us, Jason, that they heard a whisper that Alan Stubbs to come in as the number two to Henrik Larsson.
I can't see that myself, you know, because he left because his wife was wanting to go back to Liverpool, but you never know as a number two. I would love to see Steve Clarke as his number two. Steve Clarke was he's been under Mourinho the lot, you know. He's one of the best number twos in the game. So whether he would want to do that, I don't know. But as I've said before, I don't think Henrik Larsson plays second fiddle to MD. So if he comes in, he's got to be the man. But Paul mentioned it the other day. Larsson must have some amount of contacts in football.
Mm-hmm.
If Larsson's coming to take the Celtic job, I mean, he could have somebody
from
Barcelona or anybody lined up, you know. I don't know.
Well, I seen Ronaldinho was saying last week that he wanted to finish his career at Celtic, so maybe he could come in as number two player coach. Would you like that?
You think if Henrik was coming in and it was all organised before the normal Joe Bloggs fans heard that his perfect number two would have been there already, and Johan Mjelvis, you know, his pal, you know. Swedish international mates and Celtic mates.
See, if you get Larsson, you might be able to convince Ibrahimovic to finish his career at Celtic or not.
There you go.
It's getting better by the minute.
Well, Ibrahimovic did say he would like to play at Celtic before he hangs up his boots, so who's more likely to bring him? Henrik Larsson or Owen Coyle?
Well, definitely Larsson. Definitely Larsson's getting his job tonight. He's only playing the Nooners. Definitely.
There was pictures on Twitter just before we came on air. I meant to mention people were tweeting pictures Paul Lambert at Glasgow Airport.
He could be at Glasgow Airport any day of the week. It's nice 10 minutes
down
the road.
Oh well, there you go then. So Snake, I mean, I've asked everybody else who's called in just before I move on to our next caller. I mean, who is your money on the table, who do you want to be the next Celtic manager?
If you're asking for the point of view of getting bums on seats, then it's Henrik Larsson. I'm no averse to Jackie Mack and that crowd getting the job because they've got Celtic at heart. And something we've got to remember is we need somebody that knows what it's all about, because our supposed rivals across the city could be rejoining us shortly. And we need somebody that's
going to... No rejoining us.
Oh yeah, sorry, Rory. Well, rejoining us in
entering the party.
Oh, aye, sorry. I forget sometimes.
I know.
I'm away in the mountains, guys. Forget that, you know. Whatever happens.
You bother hiding it.
Try Janoshik. It's the Rang Mountains, man. Whatever we do, we shouldn't be bringing Lubo in to help him, because his coaching career is, to say the least, suspect. Oh, the team he managed, I think, got relegated. Or the coaching he did for one team. Whatever it was, they were way doing the bottom of the league here, so we'll talk about that. But Larson for the glamour, Jackie Mack, if not, and after that, I don't see the likes of Paul Lambert coming to Celtic, I don't think.
I
don't see Malky Mackay as being somebody everybody would gravitate around. And I don't see MD really putting their hand up and say, yes, please, Gizzo and Coyle. So, you know, Henrik Larsson, if he's still got the contacts, knows the Scandinavian market. I'm not buying into the Bangura thing, in case MD says. So, let's hope we get the right guy in. And he's got a year to get this team right, to be absolutely running at the top every day, much more even than Lennon did. So, whoever it is, let's hope we get the right guy in, a good number two, and let's go for it. But this Champions League, see if we can get into that this year. We're in a really, really strong position coming into the following year. So, hail, hail, lads. I hope you're all doing well back in Scotland. I might be back myself for a wee while soon. Hopefully, I might meet up with you if I am. I'll let you know.
Definitely, mate.
Cool, man.
And I hope to go to at least one of the Celtic games for the Champions League soon.
Excellent.
Could be playing Slovan Bratislava this year.
There you go.
Well, stay at your house.
As long as it's not our media, we'll be alright.
Did you, well, by the way, before I go, do you know what happened to our media?
Never heard of them since they beat Celtic.
Well, no, but they went out of business. Because there was all the dodgy.
They changed their name to a crazy name, didn't they?
Well, they were originally Art Media Petrjalka, which is kind of reached like Drum Chapel in Glasgow, kind of thing. And then they changed it to Art Media Bratislava, and then they changed it to something else. But they were out of business because they were fiddling tax or something. See, we've got a lot of that going about.
Aye, we know.
That Art Media team we played, they were actually getting funded by questionable people I know at the time, so if we're going to be coming to Slovakia, you boys are welcome, but I don't live in Bratislava, so we can stay somewhere better.
Right, Snake Man, thanks for the call, brother.
Okay, good
cheers, man.
Right,
I'm going to add in flawlessly this time.
Terry,
who's in there?
Terry's always at a good point.
Right. So add people, Terry O'Neill. Been good tonight so far?
Yep, callers.
Terry?
No, he's not connected yet.
Oh, is he not? Terry?
How's it going?
How you doing, man?
You all right, Terry?
Aye, not bad.
How you doing?
The floor's yours.
I think just put my Tom's worth in about Lenny's successor.
Yep.
First of all, I'd just like to say my favourite tweet I saw today was for Dominic Diamond. I thought he summed it up, and it was a good praise. Lenny said, thanks for the memories as a player, a manager, and someone that upped them immeasurably and stood his ground. Hashtag we are all Neil Lennon. I thought that was a good tweet. I saw the interview with Neil Lennon on Sky just through the airport, and somebody mentioned to him about the situation surrounding them leaving and that, and he said, and I thought this anyway, it's not been an overnight thing, they've been talking about it for a while, which tells me Celtic have probably sounded out a few possible management candidates. Although, on the face, it's a bit of a shock to us today.
Yeah.
I dare say Celtic and Neil Lennon, I spoke about this weeks ago, and when I started to see like wee snippets in the paper about Lenny would consider working in England, then I saw him on match of the day, and then I saw him in something else, I thought, wouldn't it surprise me if he leaves? But still, when you get the news of the day, you think to yourself, up mate, it's happening. But my candidates, I know I was listening to Brendan just as I came on. I hadn't heard the show earlier. I heard Brendan's call and he was saying that it was quite funny how the likes of a legend status like Henrik can overshadow a lack of experience, because in the one breath he said that while I liked Jackie, he didn't think he had enough experience. Well, Jackie's got more experience than Henrik.
Exactly.
But he wouldn't mind seeing Henrik in the job. And I understand that and all, because Henrik's box office, but having a mere practical heat on, Henrik's not got much experience. And then again, you think, does he need much experience? I think I could manage Celtic.
But wait a minute, but Jackie McNamara's only managed part of... Wait a minute, Jackie McNamara's only managed part of Thistle and Dundee United for a few years. Still, Henrik Larsson's been in management for 5 years.
I think McNamara, like a lot of managers that I like, I think you can tell when you've got a good manager, you see within a short space of time that their teams seem to have a recognisable pattern of play. And I think Jackie's teams tend to play it in the deck. They tend to be, they get the ball forward quickly. There's none of sideways stuff. Although the cup final, they were pish poor. But I think he's a Celtic manager in the making. That's maybe the job's come up too early for him. I always think that it's like the usual suspects come up. It's all the ones that's ever been linked with Celtic in recent years, like, what do you call him?
Coyle.
And
Moyes.
I noticed the guy the night the Norwich manager's been appointed, at Neil Adams. So yep. Up until about 9 hours ago, Malcolm Mackay was a hot favourite for that. So when they rule him out, the fact that he's not got the job, maybe he's gone to Celtic, I don't know. That's the kind of way your mind starts to go. But if it was up to me and I had a choice, I would bring I would look to somebody like Michael Laudrup and Martin Vikkors's assistant. You've got a combination there, somebody that's got a European outlook, an attacking outlook, and you've got the Celtic connection, somebody that's been here. I don't know whether it's realistic financially, if he's looking to get back to the Premier League. I don't know what the situation is, but on the face of it, is somebody looking at available candidates. I know he's not got a job in there. That would be somebody I would be looking to approach. Maybe he's already been sounded, I don't know.
See, in that point, Terry, see all my mates in Liverpool, see all the Everton fans, see when they were getting the success at the Moyes,
yeah.
Every one of them was wanting Michael Laudrup. None of them were wanting Martinez. You know, it was. See, if it was between the two of them, you'd have got, oh, it'd be 90-odd% would have took Michael Laudrup, just because of the way he had that Swansea team playing. You know, and they looked as if they were onto something there, and he's out of the game now, you know, but it's a fair shout. Liam, my mate Brummy Boy, he asked my text, they took they both names. So is Vikhorst his assistant now? Or just
he was his assistant.
Was he? Aye, right. Aye. Right, okay. So they're both Danish anyway, so yeah. So aye, he would bring some, because you come on here about a year ago or 6 months ago and you spoke about you thought Lenny had ran his race and you would like a wee shake up. And you also mentioned about bringing new techniques to the club. And
well, Laudrup had just lost his job at the time, so I'd said, because somebody said, well, who would you bring in? And I said to him, and it was more kind of, I'm a bit reactionary at times. We'd just get fucked with Aberdeen and I was raging. And I was blaming Lenny for it. And so I was just like, why do you blame somebody? And like, he was the obvious target. But even like since then, it's like, I'm not saying something died towards me and him, but I just thought, it made me start to think, well, what would happen if he changed? Would I be too upset about it? And the answer was no, I wouldn't be. I think taking everything into account, the 4 year stint is, I mean, I think Celtic are looking forward, like next year, they would probably have spoke to Lenny and say, look, you're going to be here next year and the following year. And I don't know the scenario, but it might have been a case of, well, maybe this is the right time.
I said that earlier,
just,
Terry.
Just get a guy into bed in for a year. We don't know what state they're going to be in, that Mobile City, even if they're even going to be in existence. But let's assume that there will be So I think it's the sensible thing, the right thing to do. If you've got somebody that's maybe 4 years in a job and they're thinking it's maybe enough time, it's the right time. I'm quite excited, but I always think it's exciting when something new is going to happen with your team, whether it's a new player or a new manager. With Henrik, it's just there's a lot of imponderables. The sensible bit of me thinks, nah, what experience he's got, but then you think the draw that he's got. I was watching a thing on Twitter the other day, somebody posted 242 of his goals. It was like, fuck me. About 30 goals into it, you're like, I bring him back. But it's just, you think that magic will transpire into the management side, and there's no guarantee that it will, because it's two different disciplines.
I'm willing to gamble, mate.
I will. I wouldn't be too upset if he ends up with a gig, but personally, if it was down to me, I'd be trying to get somebody like Michael Laudrup, and somebody, I want an attacking philosophy at Celtic, so somebody with an attacking outlook will do me. I don't want a
nice.
Boys practical, too practical a manager. I want excitement.
Oh, excellent points, mate, and I don't disagree with it. You know, I think, see, if we went for Michael Laudrup and Morten Vikhorst, I think the fans universally would be delighted by that.
Right. Johnny, I'll bring you in on that. You've been a wee bit quiet. What do you think about the Laudrup Vikhorst suggestion?
I heard it today. He's in the running. He started off well with Swansea. Was it Swansea? Swansea?
Yep.
Aye. They were playing great football. I think the European adventure they were in took it out of them. The squad no big enough, but definitely played great football, brought in two or three good players. I liked the striker for Spain that he brought in, but he fell away as well. I didn't actually know it was Big Morton, it was his sidekick, until I noticed it one night on my mate system, that's Morton Vikhorst. But it just seemed to go wrong for him. Will he come to Celtic?
I don't know.
I reckon with his brother, obviously he had the most success in his career at the Rotten Mob. You know, and I think his career took a nosedive when he left and went to Chelsea. You know, that was his career sort of over. So he probably looks back, and if he went to his brother, you know, and said to him, what's it like there? I think he'd get nothing but glowing recommendations.
And see, as well, for somebody like Michael Laudrup, who probably maybe wants to go back to England at some point, you could look at it as Celtic could be a great place to come and rebuild your career, rebuild it, kickstart it, if you like.
I think with him, Harper, see, be playing with Real Madrid and stuff like that. He, I don't think he's got any great visions of going back to England. He would go to Spain. He would go anywhere. And another thing, if you get him in, the contacts that guy's got in world football.
Yeah.
You know that. I think you've sold me, Terry. So I would go for that, but.
Can I jump in here?
Aye.
Go for it, Johnny.
See when Liam Brady came to Celtic?
Aye.
That was all they said about him.
I know, I keep thinking
that.
I thought about that day as well.
Arsenal went from Milan, they played with every day in Italy. And don't get me wrong, for a wee while they played no bad for Celtic, but the guy just didn't cut it, you know what I mean?
Terry,
as Terry says, it's exciting. It's going to be exciting for 2 or 3 weeks, isn't it? If it's going to be that. We need to get a manager in soon. We've got the World Cup, then we're back at it again.
Terry, anything you want to add before? Because I've got another caller lined up, man.
I just, the qualifiers, I think barring getting one of the Swedish teams, we should get through the qualifiers. I've not looked too much. I actually think that, for instance, as long as we get a replacement, if we're going to sign Sel van Dijk, I think the fact that he's not going to the World Cup is a good thing from a transfer point of view. I think we might have him for an last season.
I agree.
Maybe we'll lose a goalkeeper, but goalkeepers I think you can get. I'm quite confident, though. As long as we don't totally blow it, I can't see us no getting through the European qualifiers. I think we're blowing that out of proportion.
Right, because Terry,
likely to meet is we'll fucking blow them half apart.
I mean, when you think about it, right? Say our third game, we get a team with equivalent to Shakhtar Karagandy. You should be able to pick them out without a manager.
That's it.
You know, with the players that we've got at our disposal against fucking Shakhtar Karagandy, yeah. Come on.
Because we've got, let's not forget, any manager's coming in is getting a good fucking squad to hit the ground running with. Like,
another thing I was going to say is, see, Lise, I know we signed a few duds. I mean, Borgta, I know it's a bit harsh, but as soon as I seen him getting stretched off after 20 minutes, I was like, get him to fuck, he's never going to be a player.
Yeah, I'm right, I'm with you
on
that one. He was
the
new Martin Hayes,
that you. And you can tell, I think, you've been going to games for years, you can tell when somebody's, there's just the way they're running and all that. It sounds a bit mental, but I think you can tell. The other thing I was going to say is, although we signed a few poor signings, I think Griffiths is a fantastic player. I think he's totally underrated. See, apart from his goal scoring, see his first touch and his vision, the way he can kill a ball, I think he, providing somebody can get him to screw it in that half a park, he's an outstanding player. To me, he's every bit as good as Hooper.
See, do you know what I think as well, Terry? I think he could be our European talisman. See when you're up against it and you play with one guy up front, he dragged that Hibs team himself and got nearly 30 goals in one season with the worst Hibs team in living memory.
I think he's a tremendous player. Give him chances, the guy will score at any level, I think.
Yeah.
We just need another good centre forward. I like Stokes, but I think I'd like to see another good centre in there, and I'd like to see Tony Watt getting brought back and get Baldy and get Pookie and fucking Boric turn the first boat to China.
Well, yeah, that's another thing. That's another thing we've not touched on. That gives an opening to Tony Watt. Because any new manager comes in, it's going to haul him back in, surely.
What's
that? We've got a tweet here for Thomas Clark, right, just while I've got it. He says, at Big Time C on Twitter, if it's just about, this is going to be on the Wally McStay straight away, no, but if it's just about throwing names into the discussion, what about Di Canio?
No
danger. No, exactly, no chance. I just wanted to read out his tweet. Terry, I'll need to let you go, man, because I have got a guy who's been waiting for ages to come on.
It was a pleasure, guys, as always.
Terry, brilliant. Thanks a lot, mate.
See you later, Terry. Cheers, mate.
Cheers, Terry. That was really good. Michael Loudrop's it's one that I hadn't really thought about. It's one that I would actually, that would excite me, Jason.
Really?
Right, wait a minute. Have I hung up news? No?
No.
Oh, right, Denzel. Our people. Denzel Washington.
He's never heard that before.
It's ringing.
I'm just pouring myself a new drink of water here. Sorry, the tap's on.
Water?
Yeah. I'm on my 5-2 diet.
5-2 diet. I can give peace. Denzel's no answering.
I don't know.
Denzel, if you're still listening, you're still showing online there, so... just call back. If anybody else wants to call in, feel free. Jason, you've got the phone number.
I've got the phone number. I did have it. I put it on the chat room. Give me a wee sec, mate. I'll scroll back up and see if I can... Oh, shit. I was wondering why that water wasn't going cold at the hot tap one. Oh, yeah, dancer. Hello, China. Let me see.
It's what
Peter
Mabert's
going to grab my
phone. Here's Denzel. Happy days. Jason telling us something as well. Denzel, you there?
Alright, guys, how's things?
Thanks for waiting, man. You've been very patient.
I know, worries, guys. Nothing to do anyway. And by the way, I, Denzel Washington, here all the fucking time. I live in America, man, so everyone's always saying, like, what the fuck, man, you ain't black, man. And give me all that shit, man, so... Believe me, I hear it every day.
So you're in America then out?
Aye, mate, Arizona. I've been living here for the last 5 years.
Ah, very good. My wife's lived in Phoenix. Do you live near there?
Aye, that's where I live, right beside Phoenix Airport, actually.
My wife's uncle played for Phoenix Inferno. It was a 6-a-side team, played there for 6 years.
Oh, there they are. Aye, there's a new team right now in Phoenix. They just started one, but funny enough, it went bust as well. Kind of had a Rangers situation going on over here. They fucking, aye, apparently board members screwed them over or something, but they're trying to get a team into the Major League Soccer, so I guess it's like all these teams are available to get into it, so they're trying to figure out which ones. Really? So, aye, so fuck my, I went to a couple of games, it was not bad.
So what's your views on Lenny situation?
Like so. No DiCario anyway, he's a fucking fascist.
Hello?
I can hear you, Harper.
I can hear you as well.
I think Denzel's having problems. Denzel, you there?
Aye, what, can you hear me?
I can do it, aye.
You cut off a wee minute there.
I was just saying David Moyes, I think it'd be a good way for him to get back into the game. I think it'd be a good setup for him, but I don't know how much wages and stuff go for managers. How does that work?
Fuck him.
Jason,
Denzel, you asked the question, and we touched on it earlier about the wages. Jason, what was David Moyes on at Man United?
Well, he was on $60,000 a week with Everton, and I believe Man United maybe doubled it.
And Lennon was on about $10,000 at Celtic.
So David Moyes would be on $120,000 a week with Man United. Lennon was $10,000 a week with us. So,
aye, so well, fuck them for David Moyes, I guess. But aye, he just get something happened with him as well in a car park last night, didn't it?
Aye,
he did. Stuck
me
eating Sunday in a
labour. Get him, man.
Thanks, man. See, that's the type of man I want in the job, man.
No.
But anyway, guys, I've just got it. Aye, but anyway, guys, I was just calling in. I'm literally just heading to work right now, man. But it's my first time calling in, listening to you guys all the time. Fucking wake up, listening to Joe McKenna. All right, guys. All right. How's it going, man? Every time, man. So, keep it going, man. Love the show. And hopefully call back later whenever I'm smashed at my nut. But enjoy the rest of the show, guys.
Cheers, Denzel.
The best, Denzel.
See you later, Denzel.
Bye.
Right. That was a bit mad. Right, I've got another two callers lined up.
Right.
So, Krauske.
TP starts saying he's David Moyes pitch.
Krauske. What's happened to him? Krauske, you there? Long time listener, first time caller. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, mate.
Yep. Not me. Oh, you're there, man.
There, mate. Harper, I'll need to take these controls the next time. You're brutal.
He's there, he's on.
Right.
Aye. I'm not sure if it's him, mate, if I've got to.
He's breaking up.
Dude, ring me back.
Krauske, I'll ring you back, aye.
When do you think we'll appoint the new manager?
I think it'll be pretty quick.
Just watching the quotes we got asking Henry Larson on teletext and things like that, it looks like him, to be perfectly honest with you.
It'd have been
a lot of things. I'm happy to hear the news when Celtic come along. I've always wanted to go back, things like that.
I can't get Krauske.
Twitter came out with a belter about Marcelo Bielsa. Oh, he's always the way to Marseille. But that'd have been the dream appointment for me.
Right, here now, Krauske, are you connected now?
Aye, that's me, mate, aye.
Right, aye. Happy days, right.
Speakers are nightmare, see with an Android phone, it's a nightmare. So I had that still on, so I was hearing two things at one time. So, history was definitely.
Go on yourself, mate, go on yourself.
Explain why. No, listen, see Terry O'Neill, that man, honestly, you can listen to that man talk all day. Honestly, talks such a good game, I mean. I don't know. I can't see Moyes. Moyes would never come anyway. I'm really just saying Moyes is more just a wind-up to Jason than anything else, I mean. I can't. He's on too much. Don't get me wrong. He's obviously, what they're talking about, my Nike paid him off in single-figure millions. So that's less than £10 million he said he had a pay-off. Right. So whether he wants to maybe use selling for a year or two, come back in for a year or two, and man selling, I still can't see it. If you want too much money, if you want to spend a bit of money, I can't see Sal gaining the money he's won. No, unless he's...
But what's he going to bring to the table, right? I want you... Because the end of the day, with Everton, he was always like just sort of fighting against the odds and scraping out draws. He never won one game away from home to the top four in 10 years. So what's he going to bring to the table? Is he going to bring like fast, flowing, free attacking football?
No, well, see, my view of Moyes' tenure, right? Moyes was with Everton how many years? 10 years?
10 or 11.
See, yeah. Moyes is such a bad man, he would have been sacked, I mean, well before that.
No, he ran a tight ship, you know, he achieved mediocrity. He achieved it. For his first 6 years, for the first 6 years, I think he nearly got them relegated to... Two of the 6 years. I think they finished like 15th and things like that, a couple of the years, or maybe three of the years.
So we're talking maybe 2 or 10 years we're talking about then.
Maybe three. I don't know exactly. They qualified them for Europe a couple of times.
They got when he was at Everton.
Got them to I supported them, if it was not an Everton game, but at the end of the day you realise now what Everton can achieve when they've got a good manager. Somebody
that's
willing to play attacking football.
I just
don't know what David Moyes would bring to Celtic. I'd much rather have Jackie McNamara.
Mate, I think you'd run him up the same way Martin Hill did. I think
why do we need somebody that builds his game on like a defensive type game and he's like an old time British type manager? Why do we need a manager like that at Celtic?
You're talking
about no call for the Champions League and Park Heed being empty. Well, see, if we're winning 1-0 every week playing shite, you watch that stadium disappear.
I don't agree with you, mate.
We 99 points last year, one of the highest totals ever, and the stadium's half empty every week. We played quite good football quite a lot of the weeks. You're talking about playing bad and winning 1-0 every week.
I've always said that when Gordon Strachan was there, they hounded him out. His football wasn't great. They were winning most weeks.
I think that kind of proves the point. But does that not prove the point, Johnny? Gordon Strachan, what you said there.
Sorry, mate.
Does that not kind of prove the point, though? What you just said there about Strachan. At the end, the football was just so boring. People just weren't interested.
Listen, mate. It might have been, but we were winning. That's all I care about.
I remember winning as well, but in the right situation, if it was in the UEFA Cup final in Seville, I would have took playing shite and winning 1-0. But when you're playing at home to St Mirren, playing shite and winning 1-0, nah. One-off games, aye, but under Davy Moyes, I think that'd be maybe a bit of the norm, but obviously.
I'll take you back to 1995 and onwards to win the league. We played great football every week and won fuck all.
No, but I'm not on that either. There's got to be a fine balance.
Aye, but the fine balance for me
I'm just thinking, what's Davy Moyes going to bring? Davy Moyes is old news. You know the type of football he plays. It's not great to watch.
I don't think you've seen the guy go he's a great manager. He's been in a Man United dressing room full of fucking prima donnas who half of them will be shut out when this new guy comes in. He never got the chance. Fergie got out at the right time. The guy's fucking... I agree with, sorry, I forget the guy's name, although it's unlikely with the money situation when you explain it. For the life of me, I couldn't believe it when you said Neil Lennon was only £10,000 a week. I thought it would have been more than that.
£400,000 a year, we were told. Eh?
Nah, I can't see Moyes just coming. The money's not going to be there for Moyes.
Oh,
he's not going to come in by a yes man. As much as I love Lennon and
Moyes went by a yes man. Moyes has been a yes man all his days. Moyes was a yes man at Everton.
Aye, he was a yes man at Everton, right?
Yes man at Man United. He was listening to Ryan Giggs.
But now what you'll find now, I reckon now, he's got a bigger stature now. So
he's learned from one big mistake that he'll never make again.
See if
Alan Pardew was to get the sack, I bet you any money Moyes would be a name on a Newcastle job. See if Allardyce was to get the sack, he'd be a name on a West Ham job. Moyes,
Newcastle are the types of teams that should take David Moyes on. Because at the end of the day, he'll get them mediocrity, which that's what they crave for.
Well, that's not what they're crying for. Who was it, probably Malky McKay, you asked me, what's Malky McKay done? Malky McKay took Cardiff to a cup final against Liverpool, but if you mind.
Do you not think David Moyes would want to come in Celtic and make a David Moyes team? There's not any money for David Moyes to spend on Celtic.
He's got the means, he's a good team there anyway.
He never had much money to spend at Everton either, did he? There was one or two signs that actually went in and spent big money, went for Lenny. Who else is another one?
He spent a fair bit, you know, he spent a lot more than folk thing. He was signing guys like James Beattie and that for £8-9 million.
You've got to
realise Mikel Arteta took a wage cut to go to Arsenal. So Everton were paying £50,000-£60,000 a week wages. You know, he'd sign a few folk for good money. Yakubu, much did they sign him for? You know, there was a few of them.
Right, Kralski.
Then again, Jason, Neil Lennon done that as well. But every signing's a gamble. But what are the hell game boys for? He brought a lot of good players through.
He left them in a good state. You know, when Martinez came in, he had like a solid foundation there. Yeah, absolutely.
And he brought a lot of good players through, and he could maybe bring good players through. But I'll only mention Davy Moyes as who I would love to see there, in my own personal opinion. But when you explain the type of money, whether he's going to come to Celtic, I don't think so. But I would love to see him there. That was just my...
Listen, we've only got about 10-15 minutes left, right? So, Kralski, I've got one last caller lined up, Tony Cassidy. Aye. So, just Kralski, tell us who you want to be the next Celtic manager.
I think it's either just going to be the bookies not putting their money behind them, is going to be Larson. But I think, and I would be happy if it was Malky McKay, I would be.
Right. I don't think he's out the running. I think he's got a chance of getting it.
I think
he would take it.
Well, your man, he was top runner for Norwich job.
Yeah.
And some jumbled in England just turned and tweeted, I've stuck on his chat, Harper, that apparently Lennon and Malky McKay not back to Norwich job. That's why they end up going for the boy that went me. But anyway, it's a good show. I'm glad you jumped on this because it's good to talk about it, you know what I mean?
Cheers, bro.
Aye, Dave.
All the best, buddy, ones.
Okay, right, Kyle.
See you later, mate.
See you, man.
Aye, hail.
This, can you believe we've been gone an hour and 110 minutes?
No.
Right, so, final, this will be the final caller of the night, because that's getting 5 to 10. And
yeah.
I'm like, Joe, I need my bed. I'm going to have another gin and tonic first. Right, Tony Cassidy. Hopefully still hanging about.
Tony will be there. Tony's always waiting in the wings.
Tony boy. Tony. Bad connection. We're getting a lot of bad connections at the first attempt. Tony, you call me back, right? I don't know what else we can add in. I don't know if there's any names that we're missing.
I was thinking that myself.
Well, at the end of the day, see if Celtic come out with, if this hasn't been a whim, done on a whim, maybe Celtic. I've got a couple of guys for left field, some French guys, Spanish guys.
I was just thinking there, mind you, we're going on about Dermot Desmond, and who's the other guy?
JP McManus.
What about Trapattini? Was he?
Too old. Defensive. Fucking hell. Didn't even get Seamus Coleman a game.
Too old.
Brutal,
man. As
I say, Jason,
I'm only looking
for the win, mate. I know you like.
I want to see Celtic.
Where is
Celtic
Football,
the Glasgow Celtic way?
I kind of get Tony to connect. Tony, if you're still listening, try and call back. You two argue amongst yourselves a wee bit further, but I'll pull
as John Smith used to say to me, I hate football, it's Celtic, I like.
That's the Harpers about like that.
Give me a victory every week.
I know, mate.
Well, right, hang on, Tony. Tony,
are
you there that time?
I'm here, David.
Right, I'm waiting for my drink. Carry on.
How's it going, Jason? Long time.
I know, how you doing, mate? You okay?
Aye, surviving, man. Surviving the heat over here in Qatar, you know.
Aye. So, how long you been? How long you been there?
That's since January now, so.
January, yeah.
Four months, hopefully coming back next month for my birthday and that kind of thing, so should be good for a couple of weeks anyway. I'd like to see Jackie.
Sorry mate, you broke up, was it Jackie McNamara you said? Ah damn, I think we've lost Tony again. Harper, are you there?
I can only hear you, Jason.
Hang on a
wee
sec. I've not
got
these. He's still showing that he's connected.
He's obviously got a bad. Where is he calling for Qatar?
For Qatar in the Middle East, eh?
He's obviously he's disconnected there. I think he was saying Jackie McNamara.
Aye, Jackie McNamara.
I don't know. As we said earlier, it's. It doesn't really get the juices flowing, Jason, as you said, I think you summed it up, doesn't it, for me. Love Jackie McNamara, Simon Donnelly, but is it getting me excited? Nah, not at all. I'm being completely honest, although I have been swayed by the Michael Laudrup chat, but the only thing that gets me going is Henrik Larsson. It really, really does. And that is, I'm happy to admit, it is completely, for an emotional point of view,
I'm with you, mate. I'm getting carried away in a whim here with a king.
nothing statistical, nothing that he's done. I've never followed his career as a manager. It's just the one thing that floats my boat. Tony, you back?
I'm here, David. I'm here.
Man, you're going to have to talk to the Qatarians or whatever they call them for your internet connection here. All the money's gone in the World Cup, no gone on decent internet lines. Tony, you're
running off a generator here, you know, in the middle of the desert.
Tony. Was it Jackie McNamara you were saying?
Aye, Jackie, I'd like to see Jackie. I think he's 40 now. Him and Sid and Darren make a good team, and they know all about Celtic, and they're ready for action, you know. We're kind of, you know, we don't want to rush into it, but, efficient towards Champions League.
I don't want Wacko Jacko anywhere near us. Nah, he's one of that mob. He went abroad supporting Rangers in Barcelona and that. And the Rangers then. So, soil goods.
I think we've lost Tony again.
Have we? As long as we don't.
Oh, no, you're there.
I'm not a fan of Darren Jackson, mate. Sid and Jackie, definitely, but the other one, nah. Not for me.
The thing is, he'd be in the background, to be honest, you know. It'd be mostly Jackie and Sid anyway, so.
Right in the background.
Tony, what do you think of the Henrik Larsson chatter?
I don't think Henrik's a manager. I'm not really sure, of course, you know, but I just get the impression that he's, you know, he was a top player, of course, but I don't feel he's a manager. It's a bit, I don't know, maybe like Zidane and that. You know, he's not really put forward, he's not really been a manager, he's kind of been in the background at times. Henrik's had a go over in Sweden. I don't know if it's worked out too well at times, but I just don't get the impression that it's Henrik's. I mean, I don't know if Big Johan would have helped Henrik anyway, so that's, they've kind of bypassed each other, ships in the night, you know. I'd like to see Jackie. I think Jackie could do a good job, and he's not after big, massive money, and as I say, he knows all about the club, and he's done quite well at Partick, and he finished fourth with Dundee United, you know. So, he's all right. United, I think, were second highest goal scorers in the league last year, so obviously Jackie's teams like to attack as well, so...
Yeah.
Somebody's just said Craig Burley. I think they're just flinging out names that people were hating.
What about the one man, the best manager in Scotland, the new Stuart McCall, getting the lesbian out of the helm?
If he wasn't a zombie, he would have been a shoot.
He would have been a shoot.
Aye, definitely, aye.
Special. I think just
I didn't get any of that, Tony. Did you use?
No.
Tony's a Dalek. Right, I think we're just going to start wrapping up. Tony, you're breaking up.
No worries, lads. No worries.
Right, Tony, all the best, mate.
Right, cheers, brother.
Take care, lads. All the best.
All right.
So, I don't know if we're...
To summarise.
I don't know if we're any further forward.
We never are going to be anyway. Johnny, just to hear other folks' points of views.
Johnny's got his hat in the ring for David Moyes.
No. I've got my hat in the ring for whoever gets the joke 100%
behind. Even if Owen Coyle got the job, I'd be behind him. But I'm going to sit here and put my cards on the table and say I want Henrik Larsson. I think Jason's the same. And
I'd as well.
You're David Moyes.
David Moyes.
That's why the TikTok show's no happening every week anyway. It's a part of like that.
Next time you're doing it good, listen, sir, I'll be telling the boys.
Well, listen, I'd be just an early goal. You wanted to keep them. Things
change me, that's right. But then, Peter Long's the man, he'll pick whoever it is, and we just need to go with it. Simple as that.
I feel like that's 100%.
We are but only simple football fans. So at the end of the day, I like it that way anyway. So whoever we pick, we'll get behind them. And it is quite exciting. Terry mentioned it. It's exciting times, you know. We're gutted to see the back of Lenny, but it's a new dawning for Celtic, and we'll be there, whoever it's going to be. And just hopefully they can sort of hit the ground running. But it's Terry eloquently put, we should be beating the shite that's in front of us for that Champions League qualifier anyway. We've got no bad team.
See, just before we finish up, Johnny, the World Cup. You're looking forward to the World Cup. Who are we supporting?
Chile. Argentina all the way for me.
I've got money in Chile at 40-1.
People well know I didn't really watch football outside Celtic, but I'm going to try and rekindle my love of the beautiful game, and I'm going to watch the World Cup. I'm going to watch it every game that I can.
Argentina. So who are you supporting
then? Argentina. It's got to be.
Of course.
That'll do for me. Is that
Argentina, right?
All the way.
Okay.
So is that us? That's really the final Homeboys show until they appoint a new manager in 2 days' time and we'll be back on again.
So player of the tournament, you've got Alexis Sanchez of Barca, up front for Chile. He's your man. I'm telling you.
I haven't even heard of him.
Arturo Vidal, Juventus. Oh, they've got some team. Couple of Juventus players. Thing me's out, isn't he?
Aye, the horrible boy.
The cannibal. He's getting a knee in. That's bad news all the same, because he's bloody... They're in England's group.
Mm. Can't stand Uruguay, to be fair.
I can't stand him.
Yeah. I always look at Uruguay, but because they've got the same population as Scotland, and you see what they achieve in world football, do you know what I mean?
I still have that thing for years, for the 86 World Cup.
Aye, they drew 0-0.
And they kicked us off the park.
Aye.
Bastards.
I know.
Aye, that's right. And they only had to get a man sent off early doors,
too. Aye, remember it well, aye.
10 men for about 75 minutes.
That's right. No, I think it was earlier than
that. It was like 5 minutes, sorry.
Stevie Nicol missed an open goal, or no?
It was about the first 5 minutes.
He missed an open goal, Stevie Nicol.
Aye.
It was Wee Strachey that got him sent off. He was good at that.
He was a wee shite, wasn't he?
No, he was on the telly the other night, going on about it, too. I was shouting at him, I'd always made it on with Big Aiken in the final in 84, I know.
Well, he's a right wind up there to start us to this day.
He's brilliant to listen to, but that should be good on the television as well, because Lennon's from the panel as well, and me Strachan over there.
What about interim manager, the Strach? He stepped back in, guided us into the Champions League, and then just sailed back to Hamden.
Go back to. Well,
I don't know about that either.
Oh, they're the king of kings on the telly, they know.
Is he? Oh,
you see, it's all the right statements and all the rest there. So, I think you might be right here.
I don't know, I'd love it. But at the end of the day, it could turn out to be an absolute disaster, who knows, you know?
Exactly.
That's what I fear that. As you say, Jason Owners and others, but I'm always worried. I'm a worrier, you know that?
Mick McCarthy?
No chance.
Oh, no.
Right, another name that was flung out there. No.
I think we've went as far as we can go with names, do you know that?
See, these are guys that take us backwards, you know.
I think
somebody like Larson can just bring, if he can bring. But you always dream, you say that we dreamt of Liam Brady. But Liam just texted us, says the show's knackered, it keeps repeating itself.
Alright, it's alright, it's recording the round anyway.
The show's knackered, keeps repeating itself.
But maybe just on him, because nobody else is saying it. Listen, we're just fucking rambling there. I don't think it's not repeating at our end anyway, it's still recording, so the podcast will be fine. Nobody else is complaining. Tell Liam to take the fucking cotton buds out of his ears.
By the way, do you know what?
Hear the latest betting, you just want to hear it?
Aye.
12 to 1 Lambert, 8 to 1 Clapp, 5 to 1 Coyle, 4 McNamara, 72 Wilkie Mackay, 3 to 1 David Moyes, and 2 to 1 Henrik Larsson. So they're not in clear cut.
There you go.
I would say. But as Jason says, the bookies talk fucking garbage anyway, didn't they?
Can I just say a wee shout out to Liam Wright? See all the listeners that we have for this. Do you know he's got at least one complaint every week?
I know, it's fine.
That Joe's eating his dinner, that's what it is, this is that. I should repeat itself off.
Did they tell you who his dad voted for the day? What? Did they tell you who his dad voted for the day?
No.
He mentioned it in the chat room earlier on. He's not too happy.
You kept?
Yep.
Oh dear God almighty. Hey.
He's at the madam.
Right.
I went there, I voted at Green Party. I tell you, see when you were in there. See, they had BNP. They had UKIP, they had Say No to the EU, the amount of fucking right-wing parties they kind of had there. I don't know if Say No to the EU, I didn't know anything about them, but I take it they're quite right-wing as well, I don't know.
Well, we go to the polls tomorrow and there'll be any prizes for guessing who I'm voting for.
Yes. 32 County Sovereignty
come out here, whatever. Right, okay, listen, that was a great show tonight. Thanks to all the callers.
Yeah, thanks to everybody for calling in. It was really good.
Everybody in the chat room, everybody on Twitter, and I'm going to play out with Johnny Mack and the Faithful again, the Neil Lennon song that they've done, which is, it's actually a no bad B song. So, just to reiterate.
Everybody at the HomeBhoys, God bless Neil Lennon, everything
yes.
you do.
Yes, we miss Joe and Paul tonight. We'll probably be back home before the season starts, whether it's the new manager or stuff about the World Cup, or I dare say we'll be doing something, right?
Yeah, and a big hail out to Denzel.
Aye.
Our new pal.
Right.
He's
reversing up the freeway backwards, smashed it, isn't it? Right, take it easy, boys. Hail.
Joy, 'cause Neil Lennon has brought a bright and thunder to the boys. Yes, we know.
sometimes when it all seems so far away. But I look down onto the crowd and I know it's gonna change. And we're gonna keep the faith that we'll never.